Goeienaand, baie welkom by Lewende Woord. Ons is bly vir elkeen wat vanaand hierso is. Ons het vanaand 'n gasspreker, so we're going to go a little bit later in the evening to English. My English is not that delicious, but I believe our speaker's English will be very delicious. Ek gaan jou uitnooi om saam met my te staan en dan wil ek graag net ons harte voorberei vir vir die tyd van aanbidding en ek wil hê sommer net soos wat jy daar staan, dink vir 'n oomblik, hoe was jou week? Hoe was jou naweek gewees? Daar's dalk vir jou rede om vanaand bly te wees. Daar's dalk rede vanaand vir jou om dalk so 'n bietjie mismoedig te wees en dalk gaan jy deur 'n moeilike tyd of dalk worstel jy deur iets. Weet dat die Here vanaand 'n afspraak met elkeen van ons het, soos wat ons hierso is. Ek wil hierdie lees vir jou en dit so voorhou. 1 Tessalonisense, daai ene. Ons gaan nou net gemeen, that's it. Okay, gaan so, hy sê, hoofstuk 5 vers 16, sê die volgende, wees altyd deurbly, nie net partykeer nie, nie net wanneer dit goed gaan met jou nie, wees altyd deurbly, bid sonder ophou. Okay, bid sonder ophou, wees in alles dankbaar, want dit is die wil van God in Christus Jesus oor julle. Blus die gees nie uit nie, verag die profesie nie, beproef alle dinge en behou die goeie, onthou julle van elke vorm van kwaad en vers 23, en mag hy, die God van vrede, julle volkome heilig maak, en mag julle gees, siel en liggaam geheel en al onberispelik bewaar word by die wederkoms van ons Here Jesus Christus. Ek wil jou aanmoedig vanaand om in alles bly te wees. Ek weet, vir ons as springbokke is daar rede vanaand om bly te wees. Volgende week is 'n ander story, en daarom het ons nodig om altyd deur te bly bid. Nee, so hierdie week is 'n gebedsaak van Nieu-Seeland, maar vanaand het die Here afspraak met elkeen van ons binne in hierdie diens. En net so daar waar jy staan, kom ons, as jy vrymoedigheid het om jou hande in die lig in te steek, net as 'n oorgawe of sommer net saam met my bid. Here, ons wil vanaand kom en verklaar dat U is goed. Here, U is getrou, Here, U is regverdig. Here, dankie vir die voorreg wat ons het vanaand, Here, om in U teenwoordigheid te wees. Here, om U naam groot te maak soos wat ons dit nou gaan doen in die aanbidding. Here, om die woord vanaand te ontvang, Here, in ons harte oop te stel, Here, vir dit wat U gees in ons lewens wil inspreek. Here, dankie dat ons vanaand anders te kan uitstap as wat ons hier ingestap het, omdat die gees in ons kom werk het, in Jesus naam. En as jy saam met my stem, kom ons gee die Here 'n lofoffer en maak sy naam groot. Dankie aan aanbiddingsspan.
Choose the silver way, shine, bring me into freedom, you're the song, you're the song. is you, my Jesus. You open my eyes to your wonders anew. You've captured my heart with this love. There's nothing on earth is as beautiful as you.
I love.
Oh,
presence, submit ourselves to you. We declare that we're so dependent on you. We need you for every breath. In this presence, come speak. Will you come speak to every life, every heart, and every mind? Come meet each one of us this evening in a special way. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Jy dalk al klaar die persoon langs jou gegroet. You already greeted a person next to you when you came into the service. Why don't you just extend a greeting to someone next to you that you maybe didn't greet before. Introduce yourself to him or her if you need to. Vanaandse diens, hier is gewoonlik Afrikaanse diens, vanaand gaan ons 'n bietjie die mekaar Afrikaanse Engels wees, ons het, we have got special guests here from the US, Jeff will be ministering this evening, so a lot of the service will be in English. I want to share a scripture that I also shared this morning, Daniel 11:32, it says, those who do wickedly against the covenant, he shall corrupt with flattery, but the people who know their God, and then comes this incredible part, it says, will be strong and carry out great exploits. Isn't that a fantastic scripture? If you trust in the Lord your God, this scripture says you will stand strong against every onslaught that will come against you. Whether it is just onslaughts, the tide of society, whether it is personal difficulties you're going through, God promises He will strengthen you. He will make you strong in the midst of whatever you face. Then he goes on to say, and will accomplish great exploits. Now I thought about Leven of Woerd's history. Next year, February, Leven of Woerd will be 30 years old. As part of the celebration is really also just being thankful for what Leven of God has done through Leven of Woerd. By this time, we've got 6 other congregations in Pretoria. We're looking at 12 congregations eventually just in the greater Tswane area. We've got more than 40 congregations, Leven of Woerd congregations, outside of Pretoria that are in a formal relationship with us. We support somewhere close to 40 missionaries that are well-supported, effective missionaries where God uses them. We've got 4 international congregations. There are just so many things happening, and God has used Leven of Woerd in so many different ways. Maybe even ministries that has come, that was birthed here, that might not necessarily be in a formal relationship with Leven of Woerd. It's also just part of God's blessing and God's hand on this house. Now think about it. When you give, you are a partner in what God is doing right here. If God is busy doing a great exploit in the language of Daniel chapter 11, and you are an active member and you give to what God is doing here, you are participating in what God is doing here. No great exploit has ever taken place without real deep commitment from God's people. One of those commitments is also financially. So when we prepare to give our offering this evening, just search your heart. Not to give to an institution or into a bank account or into the offering bag comes that will pass you. Your heart should be to want to extend the financial ability God has given you so that it will also be effective in God's kingdom. And if this is the place where God has planted you, then God's kingdom as from here going out. Let's pray together, and with that, the deacons can prepare to take up the offering. Father, this evening, when we prepare to give our offering, Father, it is because we want to partner with you. We want to be involved in, we want to be connected to what you are busy doing in the world. And through this congregation, Father, receive our offering also this evening as part of our worship. And may this connect us to the work of God in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Deacons, you guys are welcome to just stand and immediately take up the offering. The band, are you guys ready with some of our visitors' cards? I don't know where they are now. If you are visiting here this evening, can I just ask you to raise your hand just for one moment, please? If you're a visitor, the rest of us, just give every visitor a nice, a warm hand, a welcome. You have chosen a good congregation to visit this evening. Immediately after the service, all new visitors We would like to meet you for just a quick cup of coffee immediately after the service. As you exit through the foyer, immediately through your left-hand side is our cafeteria. Through the cafeteria, we have a visitor's lounge just for a simple cup of coffee and just a nice meet and greet after the service. A couple of things from my side before we go to the family news. First thing is, there's free coffee after the services. If you're not aware of that, just ask yourself why you're not aware of that. And please stay behind, just have a little bit of fellowship whenever you can. The 25th of October, that's in 2 weeks' time, we will have a baptism service as part of the 6 o'clock evening service. So if you're thinking about being baptized or you know someone who's God is busy dealing with them around baptism and he or she wants to be baptized, that's the opportunity to invite them along to come experience the baptismal service. Even if they're not sure they want to be baptized or God maybe just got some questions or whatever, that's your opportunity to just invite that person along. This is also the start of a new term. And beginning with a new term, we also got all our courses restarting again. So if you want to participate in a course, want to attend one of the courses, please contact the church office as soon as you possibly can or go to the website, livingthewoord.co.za. Just get into the course detail. At every course, there is a little registration form you can fill in and we will receive your registration immediately. Then the last thing, for this term and for the foreseeable future, we will be hosting all the young adult cell groups on a Wednesday evening here at the congregation or here in the main building. Arnie will be leading that. So if you want to be part of a young, as you graag deel wil wees van die jong volwasse selgroep, kom op 'n Woensdag aand hier na toe. Daar sal 'n algemene bediening wees en dan breek jy ons op in selgroepe en daar sal jy geleentheid wees om geplaas te word in 'n selgroep. So hierdie dag moet jy praat om 'n selgroep te begin. Dis ook 'n geleentheid om te kom skakel met Arnie en word deel daarvan op 'n Woensdag aand hier by die gemeente. Now with that, if we can get the family news please.
Jesus meant what he said when he said, "My sheep hear my voice."
1 Corinthians 14 verse 1, pursue love, earnestly desire the spiritual gifts, especially that you may prophesy.
You know God is telling you to come, so come.
We are excited to see you at this Terms Prophetic School.
Christmas is coming, the bells are ringing, hope comes alive as music fills the air.
Dit is wonderlik, terwyl Oom Petrus se tief vorentoe kom, kan hy dalk net eers dit sê. Ek het net genoem so vinnig van die hoeveel het sendeling wat lewende woord ondersteun. Nou in die groep van sendeling is daar een uitsondering. Daar is net een organisasie wat lewende woord al vir geweldige lang tyd steun en wat ons trots is om 'n verhouding en 'n goeie vennootskap mee te hê regtig letterlik nou al oor jare. En dit is die Gideons. Vir die goeie werk wat hulle doen, lewende woord staan eintlik in 'n vir ons is dit meer as net ondersteuning of betrokke wees by bediening, dit is eintlik 'n vennootskap. Ons sê ons partner met die Gideons in die werk wat hulle doen. Dan vanaand 'n bietjie terugvoer te gee en meer bekendstelling te doen as jy Gideons nie ken nie. Verwelkom ons vanaand van Petrus se tief hierso. En voor ek van Petrus oorgee, kan ek vra dat ons net vir 'n oomblik ons oë sluit, ons hande na hom toe uitsteek en ons seën hom en ons seën die Gideons hiermee saam en ontvang ons ook daarmee die boodskap wat hy vanaand bring. Vader, dankie vir hom Petrus, Vader, en vir elke Gideon soos hy. Vader, ons eer u vir die werk wat hulle doen. Ons is trots om deel te wees daarvan, om betrokke te wees daarmee. En ons wil bid dat op die werk van die Gideons, daar werklik nie 30-voudige nie, nie 60-voudige nie, maar 100-voudige oes sal wees. In Jesus naam. Amen. Dank u, Petrus.
Waar is ek? Wat het met my gebeur? Ek kan nie verstaan nie. Die woorde is uitgespreek deur 'n jong man in 'n hospitaal in Guatemala stad in Suid-Amerika. Hy was in 'n ernstige motorongeluk betrokke en hy het bewusteloos in die hospitaal gekom. Hulle moes vir hom narkose gee. Hulle sy regterarm moes hulle afsit en hier word hy nou wakker in die saal. En hy het so paar dae daar gebly en hy het so depressief geraak dat hy selfs daaroor gedink het om sy lewe te neem. Toe kom 'n verpleegster daar na hom toe en in die bedkassie langs sy bed lê daar 'n Bybel wat deur die Gideons daar geplaas is. Sy sê vir hom, man, lees hierdie Bybel en kyk wat met jou sal gebeur. Hy vat die Bybel, hy lees die Bybel en weet julle wat, hy gee sy hart totaal aan die Here en hy word word hy opgelei as 'n predikant. En die laaste wat ons gehoor het, is hierdie is 'n ware verhaal. Die laaste wat ons gehoor het is dat hy 'n predikant is in een van die gemeentes in Guatemala stad. Dit is eintlik wonderlik hoe die Here hierdie ou klein Bybeltjie gebruik. Die Gideon beweging waarvan ek, my vrou vanaand hier is, hier's ander mense ook hierso wat ons ken wat ook saam met ons nie Gideons is. Ons deel Bybeltjies uit en die Here, die Heilige Gees doen die res van die werk. Ons werk in 190 lande in die Bybel in die wêreld en ons gee Bybeltjies uit in 90, bietjie meer as 90 tale. Nou die eerste wat ek graag vir julle wil sê is hierdie een. Misschien ken julle van hom, dit is die tweetalige testament, Afrikaans en Engels, maar ek wil ook sê, toe ons onlangs die suikerbeker hier gehad het, het ons 'n Bybeltjie spesiaal uitgebring, wat ook ander tale bygehad het, Duits en sovoorts en so aan, so ons probeer regtig die woord van die Here by elke persoon uitbring. Nou hierdie tweetalige testament wat ek hier in my hand het, word in dokters se spreekkamers, word dit uitgedeel, dit word in hotelle uitgedeel, dit word geplaas in hospitale, die van julle wat al hospitaal was, weet, as jy die bedkassie uittrek, dan is daar 'n Bybeltjie daar, en dit is net wonderlik hoe die Here hierdie testamentjie gebruik. En dan het ons hierdie klein PWT, dit staan vir persoonlike werkerstestament, hierdie deel is in groot getalle uit, en dat word ook in die skole gegee, in ons eie hoërskole hierso, Menlo Park Hoërskool, al die ander hoërskole, maar dis nie waar dit eindig nie. Ons plaas een van hierdie ou klein Bybeltjies ook in die swart skole daar in Groblersdal en al daardie gebiede word ingedeel en ons reis soontoe uit en ons gaan na die hoofde toe. Ons het 'n wonderlike verhouding met die hoofde daar en die onderwysers is pragtig hoe die Here vir ons die pad voorberei en as ons daar kom dan sê hulle wonderlik om julle hier te sien. Kom, die gee vir elkeen van die leerling 'n Bybel. Ons gee vir hom 'n Bybeltjie. Hy steek in sy sak, hy kan sy naam hier inskrywe, die weg van saligheid word vir hom hier so verduidelik, en dikwels gaan hy dan huis toe en die Bybel word gelees deur sy pa of ma of familielede of wat ook al. So dit is eintlik in hoofsaak dan wat ons doen. Die hulpgroep is die vrouens van die Gideons, hulle plaas vir Bybels in die hospitaal vir die verpleegsters en ook ander plekke word dit ook geplaas. Nou wil ek vir julle vertel van een van die besondere bedienings wat ons as Gideons het, en dit is hier in Silverton, sommer hier by ons, en ook in Boskop, is daar twee tronke, daar word die kwaadoeners vrydaande, word hulle gevang, opgesluit, en dan moet hulle maandag nou voor die hof verskyn. So ons neem ons kans nou waar om sondag na hulle toe te gaan. Ons het 'n span wat elke sondag na een van hierdie tronke toe gaan, ons het, hulle kry hulle daar, hulle harte is oop vir oortuiging vir die woord van die Here, en dan praat ons met hulle daar, en ons kry later terugvoering van hoe die Here ook vir hulle, deur hierdie Bybeltjie, ook hulle harte aan die Here gegee het. So ons is dankbaar daarvoor vir die geleentheid wat ons het, en daar is soveel terugvoer van geleenthede wat daar gebruik. Nou wil julle graag by my weet, wat kan julle jong mense nou doen vir die Gideons? Twee goeieties. Die een is, julle kan bid vir ons. Ons wil baie graag hê, ons moet deur gebed, gaan ons vorentoe, ons kan sonder gebed, kan ons nie die woord van die Here versprei nie. En die tweede ding is, as daar van julle is, wat tot bekering gekom het, en ek geloof van jy baie van julle is, en jy wil graag aansluit by die Gideons, om ons te help, om ons werk te doen, dan kan julle met my kom praat na die tyd, of julle, hier is een nationale kantoor, en hier is een paar andere mense, Philip Weideman, wat in hierdie gemeente is, en een paar andere mense wat hier is, wat in Gideons behoort, julle kan maar met hulle gerust ook praat. En dan wil ek net vir julle graag vertel het, voor ek nou afsluit, dat jare gelede, ek kan julle onthou, was daar een busramp hier in Westdene, in Johannesburg, een schoolbus vol kinders, het in die dam ingerij, en feitlik al die kinders het verdrink, al die bus het eenvoudig net gesak, en een of twee van hulle het uitgekom van die hele klomp van hulle. Maar wat vir ons wonderlike ondersteuning van ons en vir ons inspiratie was om ons werk voort te sit, ons as Gideons, is toe hulle van die lyke van die kinders uitgehaal het, uit die bus uit, het hulle, in baie van hulle, het hulle hierdie klein PWT, wat ons het noem, klein testamentie, in hulle sakke gekry. Maar, ek wil net vir julle gou dan vertel, hierdie klein bybeltjie, voorin, ons deel hom gratis uit, ons, niemand hoef hom te koop nie, want dit word aangekoop deur ons eie fondse, wat ons genereer, en voorin kan jy jou naam skrywe, laat het aan jou behoort, ons deel het ook bijvoorbeeld uit hier so by die parkeerplekke, ek en my vrou het een hele klompie bybeltjies in ons kar, en ons geef vir hom een bybeltjie en sê vir hom, sit hom in jou sak en lees hom, maar, achter in die bybel, word die weg van saligheid vir ons weer verduidelik, baie mooi, en as jy dan jou hart in die Here gegee het, dan teken jy jou naam en die datum waarop jy jou hart in die Here gegee het, en toe hulle van die kinders uitgehaal het, uit die water uit van die bus wat verdrink het daar, en die bus wat so gesink het, toe het hulle by hoeveel van die kinders het hulle bybelkies in hulle binnensak gekry, en as die bybelkie oopmaak, hy is papnat gewees, staan daar achter en ek het my hart in die Here gegee, op so en so tyd, so julle kan net besef wat dit vir die ouers van die kinders beteken het. Ek wil dan net graag ter afsluiting dan net vir Werner van der Walt, wat vir my voorgestel het hierso, baie dankie sê, bid asseblief vir ons as Gideons, laat ons nie moet lui wees of achter nie ons werk getrou te doen nie, ons steun op julle gebede, en baie dankie vir die geleentheid.
Dankie om Petrus, ons net om vast te vat, as jy kan bid vir die Gideons, as jy betrokken raak, praat met om Petrus na die tyd, of as van die pamflette wat om Isaac na die ochendienst gelos het, met die Gideons kontakinligting in, en as jy speciaal of specifiek vir die Gideons iets wil gee, daar is baie maniere, ek denk dat die makkelijkste is, merk dat net enige bijdra wat jy hier maak vir die Gideons, ons sal seker maak, toe kom by die Gideons uit, jy is natuurlijk welkom om te reken die Gideons ook te gee, maar dat is ook maar die makkelijkste manier. Nou, ek kan daarmee ook net bijvoeg vir vandagse dienste, ons het volgende twee gastspreker gehad by die ochendienste, en vanavond ook, ons het direct na die dienste overgave by die deur, waarom ons bedienaar sien, so hou dit maar net in gedachte. But now is my privilege to introduce Jeff McCullough, sorry for the pronunciation, this evening, please come up. Now, I honestly only met Jeff, not at a hairdresser, but just before the service, and so normally I'm very prepared to introduce a guest speaker to you, but I can say to you guys, I can say this, any friend of Leon Kotz is a friend of mine. Okay, and Jeff he heads up the ministry, Jumpstart 3. He's got a radical ministry. God is using him tremendously. And there's so much of his testimony that I presume will also be part of this evening service. You will thoroughly enjoy him. Can we also just extend our hands to Jeff and his whole family, and with that also to receive them, with that I'll give over to them. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for Jeff and his family. Father, we receive them as your servants and as your messengers. Father, as we receive them, we also open our hearts and our lives to receive the message that you have for us through them this evening. We bless them. We bless their ministry in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jeff.
How are you guys doing tonight? Praise God. I saw some Mohawks walk in. Are there some Mohawks in the house? Come on, stand up. Come on, stand up. Yeah, look at that. Woo! Okay, I think we should just get this out of the way real quick. Yes, I have a pink Mohawk. I know. Who has a son in here? Anyone? Any fathers in here? Any mothers in here? If your son says, let's go get a haircut, just you and me, Dad, make sure you get notes from Mom as to what she would wish for you to have on your son's head when you come home. Amen? Okay, I promise three things tonight. A, we're going to have a lot of fun. B, we're going to hide God's word in your heart in a way you maybe have never done. And three, we're going to hear from God because he has a word for your lives tonight and for mine too. We come from Southern California. We live in a little town called Escondido. Escondido means hidden. But even though it's hidden, it's funny. I've always thought of that. But it's a place where we learn to hide God's word in our heart. Amen? There's a business there who we've worked with for years. It's Talking Bibles International. They've translated the Bible into over 360 languages. It's amazing. I see the work of the Gideons and the effort that people have put to take the word of God out and give it to people in the way that they can receive it. And I come to tell you that there's a lot of different ways that people learn. Amen? Some people can't read. Some people will never read their entire lives. I was one who didn't learn to read until eighth grade. That's how God made me. My eyes can see you, but reading is very difficult for me. But my ears, they are my superpower. When I was 5 years old, I could listen to a song on the radio and walk up to the piano, and out it came. No one ever taught me to do that. Everyone say gifting. Awesome. Gifting is an amazing thing. We don't choose our gifts, but we can embrace them. And it's a wise man who takes a look at his gifts and doesn't take his pride in them, but gives God glory with them. Amen? Okay. So before we get too deep into our testimony, I just want to say very simply, my son and I went to go get a haircut. Let's come back to this. And he says, Dad, I want a mohawk. And I said, great. Mom's not here. You'll have a mohawk. We'll take a picture. We'll scare her. And you'll get your haircut normal because who was a mohawk? And then he says, Dad, you should get one too. Oh, boy. And then, of course, the girl at the salon goes, come on, Dad, be cool. Now, what are you going to do, right, Dads? Okay, now we both have mohawks. We're getting ready to take our little selfie. Here we are. And guess who walks in? Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Supermom walks in. Come over here. Everyone say hi, Christina. This is my beautiful wife. Everyone say hi, Andrew. Now, we have this amazing family. I love my family. We don't always understand each other. But we love each other. Amen? Okay, so here's the crazy thing. My wife's father raised her to believe that anyone that looked different than him was weird, and weird is bad. Yeah? Okay, if I come walking down a dark street towards you, would you be like, Okay, but it's funny, when I have my son with me, people go, oh, so cute, you guys have mohawks, you match. Why is it different? So my wife looks at us, and this is what she says.
You're going to make a rebel out of my son if he has hair like that.
Now, I have a question. Has anyone ever taken their child with behavior problems to the barber to get a haircut and had it change their child? Anybody in here? I'd love to hear that testimony. My father was a famous hairdresser. He cut thousands of people's hair every year. He traveled the world, in fact, with Vidal Sassoon and different people. And I saw him cut hair, and never once did it change the character of a man or woman whose hair he cut. Now, here's the striking thing. We had just put our very first song together where we took the word of God and we combined it with modern music so that my kids and myself and my wife could memorize it. And that first scripture we put out was 1 Samuel 16:7. It says, the Lord does not look at the things that people look at. People look at what? The outward appearance. But the Lord looks at the what? What's that, church? The what? This is a participating service, all right? So I'm going to keep asking the question until it's loud enough. I'm used to kids' church, and so you guys got to step it up a little bit. Here we go. All right. So the kids are going to come down here and show you how it's done in a second. So if it's true that the Lord looks at the things that are inside, and people look at the things that are outside, if it was true that our outward appearance really changed who we are on the inside, that verse would be invalid, wouldn't it? It would. So here I am in a conundrum. My wife is telling my son that his whole core being will change and he will become a rebel because of this. And so I had to stand and say, great, now we have to keep these Mohawks to show you you're wrong. Right? Because, man, we got to be right. Yeah? Yeah, no. Because this is what happens. This is where pride gets you. But here's what God did. Now, this was on October 11th, and I thought, you know, we'll just wear it till Halloween. I'll tell everyone it's a costume. They'll think it's cool. What? Hold on, Andrew, what year was that? October 11th? 2011. It was going to come off on Halloween, I promise. I was going to have proved my point. I figured I'd call church. I was leading worship at a church like yours that was televised and live streamed, and I figured if I call them, I said, look what's happened. My wife, we had this. Now I have a mohawk. It's okay. I'll take it off if you say. And then, see, then it's their fault, and then I'm still right. They said, dude, you have a mohawk? So many people will come to the church now. Really? And then what happened changed my life. People started stopping us on the street every day. Today, five people came up to me and went, oh. Now, normally I'd say, it's not nice to stare and point. Now I just tell people, smile when you're staring, and then you look friendly. But they ask me, why do you have that mohawk? And immediately I say, because the Lord does not look at the things that people look at. People spend their time looking at the outward appearance and judge whether they want to engage someone or not. They decide their worth. They decide their value. They decide whether they want to even bother with someone based solely on the outward appearance. They decide whether someone has need or is sufficiently taken care of based on what they see on the outside. But the Lord takes time to do business with our what? The Lord is brokenhearted tonight. There's people in this room that are hurting. This is not how I planned the service to go. It's not in my notes. Thank you, Lord. When I was planning my set list, he just spoke to me that rather than just a super fun family service, which we're going to have, he wants you to know that no matter how perfect your church uniform is and your church face, that you could have a broken heart and maybe have never told anybody what you're dealing with, but he knows it. And he wants you to know tonight that he loves you. And I want you, church, tonight to know that it's time to look past the outward appearance with people. Because there's people who need to know Christ in your town. Amen? There's people that need to know Christ in your family tonight. Amen? I'm going to start by teaching you guys a song. But before we do that, I'm going to do a scripture quiz. Now, I don't do this to embarrass anybody, but I do this as a simple thing. Everywhere we go into rooms with 5,000 senior pastors, and I'll ask them for a verse, and I'll say, I've got, you know, 500 rand for the first pastor that comes down and says this verse. I've never given a cash prize out. One time I offered a trip to Maui, and my daughter went, huh? Dad, you can't do that. I said, I could offer $1 billion. Because in our generation, we hide God's word in our where. Hold them up. Come on, show it. Please, Gideons, hand out iPhones. That'd be cool, right? No. We're supposed to hide God's word in our books and keep them on the shelf safely put away, right? Andrew, where are we supposed to put it?
In our hearts.
Amen. So, I must ask, who of you knows Matthew 7, 24 and 25? Come on down. 500 rand for the first person. Cash money. Cash money. Come on. Not all at once. Okay. Well, you know it. Okay, stand over here. You get a ride home to America. That's your prize. Okay, you guys, everyone, stand up and raise your hand if you brought your heart tonight. Okay, try again. Stand up and raise your hand if you brought your heart tonight. All right, cool. All right, now reach your hands out to the side. Now, I'm going to tell you, we come from a very conservative church. Your church flows in the gifts. Your church is powerful. At our church, we're only allowed to move our hands. Say, move your hands. We're allowed to move our feet. But we must never ring the bell in service. Amen? Okay? This is worship for our God. Just saying. Look at over here. They're like, I want to now. Don't tell me what not to do. Okay, so everyone take out their index finger and say this with me. Therefore, everyone. Now point all around the room. I want you to point to everyone. So therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine. Now that's really cool if I wrote this song, because then they'd be my words. But they're not. In Matthew 7, this is the voice of who speaking? Praise the Lord. So don't be confused that the guy with the pink mohawk is saying, everyone better hear my words. I don't write my own lyrics. I'm the biggest ripoff artist you'll ever meet. Amen. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine, these words of mine, these words of mine, yeah, and puts them into practice. Come on, church, get moving. Get that walk on. He's like a wise man. He's like a. He's like a who builds his house on the rock. On the rock. On the rock. On the rock. Now here's the problem. You're doing really good, by the way. This is awesome. I was impressed. We came in at second service today, and man, those people were into it, but you guys are louder than they were already. I'm excited. Yeah. We're going to see if this works in a second, but I got to tell you, do you know that it rains in Africa? And when it rains here, I know it just kind of sprinkles a little, right? Or does it like flood stuff and washes stuff away? If you don't have a good roof over your head and you go out in the rain, you're going to be what? Wow, you guys are sharp. So the rain came down and the spider went up. I spent so much time doing that as a kid. Like, okay, the rain came down and the streams rose. And the wind blew and beat against the house. Yet it did not fall. Yet it did not
fall.
Yet it did not
fall.
Do you know why? Because it had its foundation on the rock. On the
rock.
On the
rock.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are you guys ready to sing to the Lord tonight? It's really simple. Do what we do, say what we say. Now, before we go, it's always more fun with volunteers. Amen. Yes, you, sir, right there. You feeling Old Navy? Yeah. Oh, come on. Why did I wear a sign on? Come on. Yeah, hurry. Hurry. Everyone's waiting now. Come. Clap for him. Okay, and on this side, let's see. Striped shirt over there. Yeah. Yeah, why did I wear a striped shirt? Come on. Just a nice white t-shirt next time. It's much safer. Yeah, hey, what's your name?
Edwin.
Edwin. I got it. Okay, Edwin, what's your favorite soup?
Chicken soup.
Chicken soup. All right, good. I like chicken soup. What's your name?
I'm Donnie.
Everyone say hi, Donnie.
Hi.
Everyone say hi, Edward.
Hi.
What's your favorite soup?
Not chicken.
You would just want to be like everyone else. What's your favorite soup?
Lamb soup.
Lamb soup. Wow. That sounds good. We had good lamb last night. Okay, so you guys already know this song, right? You know the motions because you're paying attention, right? Pay attention. In my church, you can either volunteer or you'll be voluntold. Okay, take your index finger out, everybody. Say, therefore, everyone who hears these words of you're ready. Let's sing Matthew 7, 24 and 25.
Matthew 7, 24. Come on. Let's sing it.
Go!
says these words are mine and puts them into practice. Therefore, everyone who hears these words are mine.
You got it.
These words are mine. These words are mine.
Like a wise man.
Ooh,
that's right.
He's like a wise man who built his house on the rock. House on the rock. House on the rock. House on the rock.
Come on, Baxter. Now freeze.
Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine, these words of mine, these words of mine. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice.
Hallelujah.
Go. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine, these words of mine, these words of mine. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice.
Hallelujah. Now, we call this sweating for Jesus. Hallelujah. Let us see if it works. Say it with me, church. Therefore, every who these of and is like a who. What happened next? And the wind, the wind blew and beat against that. Yet it did not. Yet it did not. Yet it did not. How come? Because it had its foundation on the. Hallelujah. Now, is that the way you do scripture memory today? Is that a little different? It's a little different sometimes. Now, when I was a kid, I learned my ABCs. And they sang A, B, C, D.
E, F, G.
Wow, that was a joyful noise. It's amazing how we understand with small children that using music hides things in long-term memory, and so we do it, but then we stop. Right? If you see information, you get 10% retention. If you see it and you hear it, you get 30%. But if you see it, hear it, and do it. Everyone say visual.
Visual.
Everyone say auditory.
Auditory.
Faith comes by what?
Hearing.
By what?
Hearing.
I can't hear you. By what?
Hearing.
Sorry, I'm hard of hearing. And then there's kinesthetic. That's when you do it. So right now, when I do this, what word is that? Good. It's a living word, isn't it? Yes, hallelujah. And when I say this, it's what? Wow, you guys are learning a vocabulary of sign language almost instantly. It's true. It's awesome. If I say this, I haven't even taught you this, but it's what? No, I'm just fanning myself. I'm really sweaty. No, it's heart. It's heart, you guys. Okay, so we're going to get down to it. It is not only critical that the word be living, but it's critical that it be living in where? So we must put it there. It takes time. It takes dedication. It takes tools. Amen? Okay, it takes having Bibles to start with. It takes putting those Bibles in a form that everyone can use. Some people have to do to learn. My brother took apart our toaster. I'll never forget. We never had toast again, but he learned. So my parents encouraged him. What were they thinking? You guys, are you ready for another cash prize? I really don't want to take all this money home with me. We're going to just do it between these two guys. Ooh, battle royale. We could put you in there and do a cage match. Okay, who knows? Because I know I've trained these children in this church. They've been with me the last few days. And Leon has been training them for months with this. He's been sending us videos back in America and encouraging us through some very difficult times in our ministry. But when we look at these videos, we see hundreds of children in South Africa worshiping with the Word of God. And they all know what, everyone say it with me. James?
James.
One.
One.
Dot, dot.
22.
Oh, come on, you could be cooler than that. Come on up. Yeah, you too. The giggly ones. Come on. Come on. Yeah, come on. Give them a hand. It's not fair for you to be down there having a good time and not showing. Okay, boys against girls. Come on, this will be more fun. Okay, everyone say James.
James.
One.
One.
Dot, dot.
Dot, dot.
That's a long way down. 22.
22.
All right, all right. What's your name?
Elise.
What's your name?
Ursula.
Cool. Elise. Say hi, Elise.
Hi.
Say hi, Ursula.
Hi.
What does James 1:22 say?
I don't know. I'm not at Bible school.
Sir, I have a question. Do Gideons only give to Bible school students, or will they give to everyone? Anyone tell me? Can anyone tell me? It's for everybody?
Yes.
The Bible's for everyone? Okay, I'm going to try over here. Gentlemen, James 1:22.
No, I don't know.
Technical timeout. Oh, this one? Oh, he's been studying. Okay, everyone say, hi-ya!
Hi-ya!
Yeah, this isn't normal church, is it? Say, hi-ya!
Hi-ya!
Now, let's replace hi-ya with, do not!
Do not!
Do not!
There
you go. Watch the boy. He knows what's up.
Merely listen.
Well, this looks familiar, right? To the
word.
Oh, you already know it. You said you didn't know it. And so deceive yourself. Do what it?
Yes.
Do what it?
Yes.
Do what it?
Yes.
Kids, if your parents will allow, please come down front. We need to show these grown-ups how it's done. Give them a hand, you guys. All right, settle down. Settle down. My friend Becky Wakerly, everyone say Hillsong.
Hillsong.
Hillsong is an amazing place where the word has gone out around the world and worship has gone out around the world. They've impacted so many people. But I'll tell you, The children's pastors, David and Becky Wakerly, they shared a verse with me that profoundly has impacted how I view children's ministry. Some people just go, you know, it's babysitting. You're just doing childcare while the real service is going on. I'll never forget, I was at a church in Denver recently, and we did a family service, and they said, adult care will be provided in the sanctuary. That was awesome. Psalm 8, verse 2. Says, through the praise of children. Raise your hand if you're a child. These are children. If you're a child of God, raise your hand. That would be everybody. Therefore, everyone. Through the praise of children and infants, you have established a stronghold against your enemies. To silence the foe and the avenger. Everyone say powerful. Where does God dwell? In praise. If you're afraid, praise. Because it establishes a stronghold. Everyone go, poof. That was awesome. Now here's the story. When your children praise God, it establishes a stronghold. It blocks the devil. It stops him from coming at them anymore. Amen? You guys, James 1:22 is the most important verse that we're going to learn tonight. It says, do not merely listen to the word, and so deceive yourself. Do what it
says.
Do what it
says.
Do what it
says.
If it says forgive, do what it
says.
If it says pray for the sick, do what it
says.
If it says love your neighbor as yourself, do what it
says.
Do you see how practical this is? If you lay this filter over your life, if this is the only verse that you memorize and you live out in your life, will your Christian walk be different? Will your homes look different if your children obey this verse? Yeah. Profoundly different. Andrew, be careful. You're on a very high stage, and I don't want to take you home in, like, a bandage. Okay. Okay, let's sing James 1:22. DJ, thank you so much wherever you are. Church, raise your hands up and sing with me.
Oh, 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 oh.
Hey, children, face the audience.
Oh, oh.
There we go.
Oh, oh.
With us.
James 1:22.
Do not merely listen to the word, and so deceive yourself.
You got it now, sing it.
Do not merely listen to the word, and so deceive yourself.
What are you gonna do, church?
Do what it says.
What?
Do what it says. Do what it says.
Now this side sounds a lot louder. Come on, you guys.
Do what it says. Do what it says.
All right, take it from the top. Here you go.
Do not merely listen to the word, and so deceive yourself. Do not merely listen to the word, and so deceive yourself.
What are you going to do?
Do what it says. Do what it says. Do what it says. Do what it says.
Love your neighbor as yourself.
Do what it says.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's bounce. Throw your hands up for the cool down. Here we go. Oh, church, you can be louder than that.
Whoa, oh,
yeah.
Whoa.
Hallelujah. Give the Lord a hand clap. Now here's where it gets fun. Let's see who is paying attention. Is it going to be the boys or the girls today? Gentlemen, cheer for your team. Go! Ladies? Now wait, who booed? Who booed? We need to have a private talk. Oh my gosh. What does James 1:22 say? Wait, you're not a Bible student, but is it okay now that I ask you? Okay. Yeah, it's good to use the motions. See what she's doing? Because what happens is when you use your motions, it stores it in a different place. It adds more information. Do you know why I asked you if you like soup and what kind of soup you like? Because when you meet someone, you get one piece of information in their name. And that piece of information comes and goes very easily. But when you get to know someone and add more and more and more and more information, all of a sudden you can remember them better. Why is it more is easier? You should keep it simple, right? But when it's simple, you forget, amen? So what we did was just added a lot of information to a simple verse. It says,
do not.
Come on, help her out.
Do not merely listen to the word of God.
No, okay, you want to steal it? They're adding to the word of God. You know what it says in Revelation about doing that? Here we go. Okay, gentlemen, you ready to go? They got do not, so help them out. Come on, you can help them out. Do not
merely listen to the word.
Okay, wow, that's cheating. Over here, one more time, go. Help us out, church. It says do
not.
What are you supposed to do, church? What?
What?
Now, I don't normally say this, but you should listen to the kids. You really should, because they seem to know this. You guys, was this fun so far? Thank you for volunteering. Hop down. I'm going to find some more victims. I mean volunteers. Go on, guys. Thank you so much. Wow. I think we should bring some kids up here. What do you think? Wow. I want to bring you all, but I can't. Okay, you. If you have mohawks on, get up here. And we need one more girl. Yes, you. Come. Okay. Everyone say new. There's times in your life where you feel weary, amen? And you need something new and fresh. Now, here's the crazy thing. I've heard people say, since I've been doing this ministry for 4 years, that, oh, we just need something new. I heard it said so many times, we need something new. But my pastor used to always say, if it's new, it isn't true. There's nothing new under the sun, amen? That was in the Bible a long time ago. So here's what we need. We need something fresh. We don't need a new kind of bread. We just need fresh bread, amen? Have you ever walked into a bakery or your mom's kitchen and that bread has just come right out of the oven and it's just, oh. Thank you, Leon. I'm speaking his love language now. And mine, clearly. But sometimes we just need something new in our lives. Now, here's the cool thing. God doesn't leave us where we are. When we have a bad day, guess what? His mercies are new every morning. Amen? Okay, I want you to stand up one more time, church. I know. You're like, we just sat down. This isn't a Catholic church. Sit down, Neil. Sit down, Neil. Okay, here we go, you guys. I want you to say this with me. Say, therefore, if anyone. Now, some of you leaned, some of you didn't. We're going to go for everyone. Therefore. Now look at your neighbor and watch him lean. If anyone is in Christ, the new creation. Now we must be mindful of international sign language and offensive sign language. Put your left hand out and come behind it, please, with your hand. Thank you. That's good. I don't want to have to explain this to a kid if you're doing it the other way. You guys who are laughing so loud. There must be the Bible school students. I'll speak to you on Tuesday. Okay, so therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. Where did it come from? It came from a therapist and a counselor. It came from a self-help book. It came from this new diet program that I just got. Clearly not. It comes from heaven, amen. Therefore, if anyone, I didn't lean, did I? Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. Watch this, church. Ready? The old has gone. The old has gone. Come on. Can we turn the house lights up a little bit? I think everyone wants to see each other right now. This is priceless. I always say with our family, be safe or be filming. So now would be a great time to film your spouse. Here we go. The old has what? Now this is where you must pay attention. The new is where? Here. In your what? Yes, in your shirt. That's right. Not your stomach. That's after church. Come on. Okay. So I'm going to do the new is here the first time. The next time I'm going to say the new is here, 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 here. And the last time, I want you to point at everyone around you. We did that earlier, right? The new is here, 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 here. Because we want revival in this place. Amen. Okay, let us sing 2 Corinthians 5:17. Thank you, guys. This is so much fun. Here we go.
Are you ready?
Okay. What verse is it? It's 2 Corinthians 5:17. 5:17. 5:17. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Here we go!
Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, that's you, the new creation has come. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, that's me, the new creation has come. The old has gone.
Come on.
Where'd it go? The old has gone.
That's right.
The old has gone. The new is here.
All right, church, you got this.
Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone.
That's right.
The old has gone.
Come on, kids, be louder.
The old has gone.
Where's the new?
The new is here.
Hallelujah. We're going to clap our hands. And I'm going to remind you that God renews your heart and your mind and your strength. All we have is capable to do through him who strengthens you. Amen? Let's sing this again.
Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, that's you. The new creation has come. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, that's me. The new creation has come. The old has gone.
Everybody, you can have a seat. Thank you. Give a hand for our volunteers up here. Kids, don't go anywhere. We are not done. We are not finished with you. You guys, join your friends. We got to make room for more. Mohawks off. You guys look great. Hold on, bust a fist bump. Come on. Okay. Is this how you guys normally do church? No, and probably never again after this. It's been great being here for my last time in South Africa. Yeah, it's so hard to choose which verse to sing. I've never in my life seen children stand up by the thousands and yell out a verse that they want to sing. That's just weird, man. But I want to leave you with one that I hope you will try to do. It's Proverbs 3, verse 5 and 6. Okay, it says, trust. Let's stand up, church. I know. You had your break. You had your break. Game on. Okay. It says trust. Trust, trust. Trust, trust. In the
Lord.
Ah. With just enough of your heart to make you look good at church. But when you go home, you can stay up all night worrying. Right? Right? With how much of your heart? Come on, show me all. With all of your
hearts.
Come on. And lean not on your own understanding. And all your ways submit to him. And he, will make your path straight. And we're running. We're running. We're running. We're running. We're running. Okay, stop it. Trust is a funny thing. It requires no action on your part. Worry requires a great deal of effort. But my Bible says that by worrying, nothing is accomplished. I cannot add anything to my stature. I cannot change anything. But by trust, did David trust that God would land that stone in Goliath's head? I remember hearing that David had more than one stone. Is it because he thought he'd miss? No, it's because Goliath had brothers. Yeah. I learned a word. That's Mal. The little boy would go out after a giant who was 10 feet tall, who was over 3 meters tall. That's crazy. But he trusted not in his own self, but he trusted in who? Did God deliver him? Now that song we sang first, it talked about a house. Is that a real house that's made of tin or bricks? What is that house we spoke of? It's us. Therefore, everyone who these words of and puts them into is like a who builds his. Who's the rock? He's to be trusted. When you build a house on the rock, it's because you trust that foundation not to move. Amen. Everyone say trust. Trust, 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 trust. I think we're ready. Are you guys ready to close out? You guys, our ministry is called Jumpstart 3. We are from America, but God has taken our songs from our little garage in Escondido to over 100 nations. And we're going to sing right now, and I want you to go home and be haunted by this verse. Every decision you make, when you come up to something hard, I want you to trust, 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 trust. Tomorrow we're going to go out and see wild animals in a regular car. And they told me, it's okay. There were some elephants that were knocking cars over, but they've gotten rid of those elephants. But don't elephants never forget? What if they're like, okay, so your turn. They'll never suspect you. Trust, 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 trust. Yeah. I'm going to be singing that the whole way, you guys. But no matter what comes your way, if it's a problem in your marriage, if it's a challenge in your job, if it's just simply wondering, will other people like me? Who loves you? So much that he sent his only to do what for you? That means you're worth it. Let's trust in the Lord. Let's sing Proverbs 3, 5, and 6, you guys. Thank you.
Trusting in the Lord. Trusting
ready?
In the Lord.
Come on.
Trust, 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 trust in the Lord.
Proverbs 3, 5, and 6.
Trust, 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 trust in the Lord.
Thank you so much. Now, I know you guys are going to World Cup, yeah? How cool would it be to be seeing the World Cup on TV and hear the whole crowd going, whoa, oh, 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 oh. What a testimony that would be. Can we make that your theme song next time you go to a game? Let's see what we can start. God bless you guys.
Give them a big, big hand. Come on, you can give a bigger hand than that one. Okay, let's just close our eyes. On Friday night, a girl came for the first time. The word of God sets a generation free. How many of you know that's the truth? She came in with a cast on her leg. Her leg was badly hurt. She had torn her ligaments. She sang the scriptures, and afterwards I went to her and I said, I pray for you that tonight you'll feel the hand of God working in your legs. This morning she came without a cast. She felt the hand of God moving in her legs. She's completely healed. So let's give God a big, big hand for that. And here's what I want to leave you with. South Africa, this is what I want to leave you with. This is why we brought Jumpstart 3 in. I was praying one night and I said, God, we need revival in our schools. How many of you agree with that? We need revival in our children's hearts. And the Lord took me to Revelations and he said, they overcame the enemy by the blood of the Lamb. So tonight, in the name of Jesus, we pray that you will cover our schools with the blood of the Lamb. That you will cover our children with the blood of the Lamb. And then with the word of their testimony. How many of you believe God's going to turn around the mess into a message and he's going to bring testimony where it seems impossible? So let's just pray together. I want you just to stretch out your hands towards these kids as I finish with praying. Bullying needs to stop. Everything needs to stop. The only thing that will stop it is the word of God. So Father God, we pray tonight. We thank you for Jumpstart 3. We thank you for their hearts. Thank you, Lord, for everything you've done. And Lord, tonight I just want to thank you for the children of this church and the children of our nation. And I want to speak over every child that you have a future and a hope, that God has a dream for you and that no weapon formed against you will prosper. Every child needs to know that God has called them by name, and even if they go through the fire or the water, God will be with them. Let's give God a big, big hand for what he's done tonight. There is an offering being taken up for our speakers tonight. How many of you would like some of Jumpstart 3's products? It's